I think I'll do OpenSSH next. So this will allow remote access into, in fact, this is probably a good one to do. It'll allow remote access into the machine. You won't have to sit at the Raspberry Pi keyboard and terminal. You can manage the installation remotely. In fact, what we can do is if I install this, I can then build the remaining packages using the remote access. That might be an idea to do that. So let's fetch the package. There's no required or recommended dependencies. So let's just get this address. Okay, and extract it. And once again, we've got a separate user for the daemon that's going to be running to act as a server for any SSH requests. Let's just check if there's any other options here. We haven't got PAM installed, so we can't add that option. What's this one here? Next authentication. Okay, we haven't got anything else installed like that, so we'll just take the default options. That should be sufficient. Right, that's built. We can run some tests, but it says to copy the SCP program into user bin first of all. So let's see where that is. If it's here, yes, it's here. So SCP into user bin, and then run the test with make minus J1 tests. Okay, that's finished building. Testing. So we can now install the package. It's a good test as well. So let's grab all of that and paste that in. If you want to prevent root login, it recommends to add this command. Now, as root is the only user on the system at the moment, I'm actually going to change this to yes to ensure that the root is permitted, and just add this anyway with the yes instead. There's some more information there about creating key files to log in without a password. And lastly, all we need to do is to add in the boot script. So let's come out of this, clear up the OpenSSH directory, change into the BLFS boot scripts, and as it says there, make install SSHD. And that's it. Normally with the boot script, I'd start it immediately because we're in a trut. It's not the responsibility of the LFS system to manage these things at the moment, like the NTP. It's responsibility of the host, so to try and start these now would be wrong anyway. So that's OpenSSH done. So what I intend to do is to reboot the machine and access the machine remotely to show you that how helpful it is to have OpenSSH. I'll access the machine remotely. I'll show how the clock is working via NTP. And I'll finish up by installing GPM to allow mouse to be used to copy and paste in the terminal, although it's a bit of a moot point where it's actually necessary when you've got OpenSSH, you can do things with a graphical browser remotely. It is still handy to have that mouse in case you lose all access and you've got to sit at the terminal and do stuff. Likewise with links, if you lose access remotely and you need to sit at the terminal and maybe browse the internet, these are sort of lifesavers. They're basic, but they do a job, so it's useful to have those two packages as well. Sudo, I would normally have installed that as well, but there's no normal user. Again, that's something we'll do as part of the process of going through the BLFS manual, which I'm not doing. I'm just cherry-picking stuff here, just to make the LFS system a bit more amenable to modification for future, and to show you how to get it into a state like that if you want to take it further. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back to the home directory. I'm going to modify the the command line file again. I'm going to delete that hash, insert the hash there, so it boots from the Linux from scratch system rather than the Raspberry Pi system. I'm going to come out and I'm going to unmount all of the file systems that I've got mounted. So not sure if you can do lists of these. Let's try it. Let's try those two. Yep, that seems to work. That's good. So I can do umount on all of these. No, not that one. That's on the main system. Okay, so if I do df minus h, no, there's no MNT LFS, so that's good. So all I need to do now is just shut this down nicely. I'll close down this browser and I'll actually shut down the system because I'm going to have some lunch and come back and see you in the next video. where I'll do what I've just said, just finish off the extra tools. So if you've enjoyed this video, I'd appreciate a thumbs up on it, and subscribe to the channel if you want to see any more. Thank you very much. Goodbye.